All right, and welcome back. So we're gonna get into the experiment here now. The experiment that we're gonna be doing is an experiment utilizing paper chromatography. So chromatography is a type of technique that is used to separate things out. We use it in forensic chemistry and we use it in forensic DNA analysis. So if we have a mixture of something and it's all together in a sample, then we use chromatography in order to pull out the individual parts of this sample and ultimately analyze those. So what are some of the things that you are going to need? You're going to need filter paper. This filter paper can also be a coffee filter, but I will tell you that filter paper works a little bit better, so we'll get to that. You're going to need a pair of scissors in order to cut the filter paper. We're going to need alcohol. Rubbing alcohol, like in your first aid kit, would work. This is alcohol that is from a lab provider. A series of black pens. It would be best if they are different types of pens. So I have a few here that are the same, but different types of pens are going to be most effective for you. We need a container. This container needs to be fairly small. We don't want it to be huge. You'll see why it is here in a second. And then some form of a support structure. We'll get after this. So I want to remind everyone, when we talk about forensic science is in fact a comparison technique. So we have to compare things that are found at a crime scene with reference materials that our detectives have brought us from individuals that they think may have committed this crime. So in this scenario, we are provided with a ransom note. So let's just generate one of those, right? So here we have our filter paper. I'm going to randomly select a pen, and fortunately I'm looking at it, so it's not super random. And I'm going to write myself a ransom note. In this, it's going to be the very offensive message of hi, right? Okay. So we have this ink that's now there on the filter paper, and we want to be able to analyze this. All right. Okay. So, ink on the filter paper. Wonderful. So this is going to be our crime scene. And this is what we have to compare to. So we're gonna set this aside for right now. In order to set up this experiment, we're gonna take some filter paper. Okay. I'm gonna grab a few sheets of this. I'm gonna grab my container. And I'm going to try to measure a little bit. All right. Now, it looks like the height of this filter paper is about the same as the container. Well, if I were to overlap this, it would be about the same. So what I'm going to do here is I am going to fold this in half, and it may be different for you. So don't think that this is the only way to go about doing this. All right, and I am going to cut right down the center of this filter paper. And I'm gonna do the same thing on this side. And I know this looks a little wasteful, but I'm not going to use those, all right? And then I'm gonna go through and I'm gonna cut this right down the center as well. Okay, it's back. Now I have four pieces of this filter paper. Great, wonderful. And I have a few pens. One, two, three. We'll just use those three. Yeah, that's different. And then the ransom note. So we'll get to that. So in this instance, these three pens are our unknown pens, right? They're our question that we're asking. So how do I set this up? I'm going to take my, and I want to barely, these all have to be flat on the bottom too. I missed that part. So let's flatten those out a little bit. All right. Okay. And I want to barely hang, so this filter paper is just barely touching the bottom. And it's not even doing it there. I cut it too short. It's all right, science works even without perfection. So we're gonna do this with two examples here, all right? So you can see that there, all right? Now, in order to make this experiment work, we are going to take these out and we're going to draw a thin line right across the bottom. So you can kind of like take your finger and then mark, can you see that? Mark right across, just a tiny little line. So that's all I've done, all right? And then we want to keep things consistent. So there's that. I'm getting rid of this different pen. Right? Here's the next experimental pen. And we're going to go through and we're going to mark that line just like that as well. All right. So now to the container, we are going to take our alcohol and add just a little bit. Now, this is going to change for you as well. What we want to do is have it just barely touch. This strip is going to just barely touch the bottom of that. And I've actually got it too far in there. Yep, I got it too far. So you want to have it just the right amount so it barely touches. And then the alcohol is going to start coming up into the filter paper. So that second one may be a little bit better than the first. It stopped dancing around. All right, so we can already start to see, let's see if I can move that a little bit closer, as you can see that the ink is starting to move up through the filter paper. So what's happening here is that the alcohol is getting pulled up into the filter paper. And as it starts to get pulled up, it's going to take the ink that's with it and have it go up as well. And this filter paper is holding on to some of the molecules in the ink, and it's letting go of others. And the speed at which it holds on to some and lets go of others is going to make it so the different inks that are inside this black ink are going to become separated from one another. You can already tell just by looking at this that I used two different types of ink because their behaviors have already changed. As you can start to see, one of them is spreading much faster than the other, while we have a nice tight band in one of those. And so we are already, from a forensic standpoint, we have already identified that these two inks are not in fact the same. But these are our two reference inks, right? We need to talk now about our ransom note. So in this, it's gonna be a little bit more challenging because I hastily wrote this note and now I need to analyze that dot that's right there. So I'm gonna try to cut that out. All right. Give this a little bit of a cut there. Now, ideally, it would be the exact same, and I wouldn't have to worry about any of this, but it's not quite. So in doing this, if we have a place like this H where we can cut that out, that tiny little band there, what we would do is place this inside our experimental stand as well. Aha. Let's see if I can try to hold that on there. Place that. Now you really wouldn't want to hold your experiment the entire time. But what we're doing is we're letting this go up into the filter paper. I'm going to try to set it down close. Watch this fall. If it falls, you're all allowed to laugh. Ah! It fell. Well, yours will do better, I promise. All right, I'm gonna push those close there so you can see it. I'll try a different part of it. Who said science wasn't funny, right? All right, I'm gonna try to get this part right here in the H. This time I'm not gonna let it go. Now what we're looking for here is that eventually it's gonna slow down and then it's gonna completely stop. And when that stops, that's when it's done. You're gonna see often about an inch or two, maybe an inch and a half of distance from where you originally put the test line all the way up to where it has stopped. And once it has stopped, that's going to be the time in which you would start collecting your data. All right. So let's see if I can hold this one while we finish it. Now, whenever we start doing any form of a scientific experiment, it's important for us to realize that science just isn't doing cool stuff. It's also the process of recording that information, analyzing that information, and then reporting it out to others so they can benefit from what you've done here. And so just sitting there and observing things is nice, and observational science definitely has its value, but we need to be able to explain to others what has gone on. And so in order to do that, you have to make measurements and you have to do calculations and analyze this. So what are some of the data that's coming from this? I'm gonna go ahead and pull these out, all right? And let's look at some of the different data on this. If we compare side by side of where we started from, you can start to see that they have completely different banding patterns. A lot of that dark ink is up to the top. You can see places where blue ink has started to come through in this. In this one here, the blue ink is also migrated up to the top. Depending on the types of pens that you use, there could be even red ink in many of these. And those would give you a good indication. So not every pen manufacturer is going to produce the ink the exact same way. So you would go through and you would compare that to the ransom note. And when we start talking about the outcomes in forensic science, not every single experiment that we run is going to give us a hard, fast answer. We have to acknowledge and realize that in the real world, you can have no as an answer, you can have yes as an answer, and then you can have I don't know as an answer. And we call that inconclusive. So in instances where there's not a clear example of what the data is trying to tell you, you would say that that is in fact inconclusive. Now, in doing this, if you let this run for longer, you're gonna get better banding patterns. If you have inks that are a lot more diverse, you're gonna start seeing reds in those. And I would say that more often than not, you can go through and identify what pen somebody wrote a note in. So once you get good at this, something else that you can do is find all the pens in your house and have individuals write a note and bet them that you can figure out which one of the pens that they wrote that note with. So I hope this was helpful for you. Hope you had a little bit of fun in doing this. You've got a kit now where you can do many of these things on your own as well. So go through, have a blast. My advice is just go have fun with it, right? Try to do as many different variations as you possibly can. Ask as many questions as you would like about it. And feel free to experiment and have fun. So thank you all for doing this, and I hope you enjoyed yourself.